Welcome back to the Grace and Andrew Yang show. I am here tonight with my co-star, Mr. Fax Machine Douglas.
Hi, Shilah Mae. When did you get down from the Swiss mountains?
What do you mean?
You look just like Heidi, the famous mountain girl.
I thought you were talking about Heidi Klum, and if that was the case, I would have to kick you in the face.
No. I
Okay,
wouldn't
good.
have that seal stealer, no. Nothing to do with her.
But you.
I noticed you have the curls and you look younger than springtime. What did you do, Shiloh?
Well, I had to get a new layer of Botox because the old one was starting to melt off. So,
Oh.
it's awfully hot here in the summertime. I'm not used to it because I'm from Antarctica, but right now I'm in the States. So.
Oh, I see. It's like when they put a new layer of asphalt on the highway to keep it smooth.
Yeah. But, and, I'm also getting a nose job. So. I just got back from the salon and
That's good.
yes. So, Fax, I remember when you reported that you once encountered an organism named Jeffrey Dahmer. But now we know that he was later tried and found guilty of 17 homicides and convicted of at least four murders, counts of murders of the first degree in year 1992. How did you encounter this organism? Full name, Jeffrey Lionel Dahmer.
Larno. Well, it's funny you should ask that. I did meet him and spend an evening with him
Oh,
in
you did.
1986.
How did you meet him?
I was at a bar with some friends, and he was there too.
Any type of
So,
bar?
what?
What type of bar?
Oh, okay. This was a suburban gay bar.
Oh, and you were there with friends?
In the suburbs of Chicago.
That your
But
wife
I
is not.
realized you had a sheltered life, being raised by penguins, so you might not know all the subtleties.
Right. So, anyway, we were saying that your bar was at Chicago. Is that correct?
It was a suburb of Chicago, which is
Same
different.
thing, because. Do you think that Lori Lightfoot, the current mayor of City Chicago, Cook County, Illinois, zip code beginning 600, frequents these settings as well?
She might have.
Do you?
But I think she pretty much stuck to the lakes and rivers she was used to.
Did you ever run into her in these types of settings?
No, because I tried, I was very proud of my shoes, so I didn't want to step in any mud. So I think I managed to avoid her.
Anyway, back to the night when you encountered organism, full name Jeffrey Lionel Dahmer. Facts, a lot of people often use the phrase killer instinct to describe acuity in instinct, as you know. So, At that moment, when you were engaged in conversation, no doubt, with a Jeffrey Lionel Dahmer, did you ever sense that he was the cold-blooded killer that he eventually came to be?
No, I'm afraid not. I thought he was a nice guy.
Take us back to those moments when you were there. Jeffrey Lionel Dahmer was speaking words to you. What went down in this conversation, Fax?
Well, after the dancing and
What kind of
frolicking and
dancing are we talking about?
what?
What kind of dancing are you talking about?
I guess disco dancing.
Oh, I thought it was a more like lewd type of dancing that you were gonna refer to.
Oh, no. Nobody twerked in those days. This is a pre-twerk society.
Anyway, proceed.
Well, you may wonder how I knew. By the way, Lionel was his father's name. His middle name was his father's first name.
Oh, okay.
I know that because I read A Father's Story by Lionel Dahmer.
Yeah, and
Ooh.
I kind of figured it was his middle name.
Yeah.
So,
But anyway, speaking of his name, when we were together at the restaurant in Countryside, whose name was a woman's name, I forget exactly what name. A good part of the conversation centered on how he spelled his name. I thought his name was spelled Daumer, but he told me it was Dahmer.
and were you surprised at this type of spelling?
Oh, I don't know. That's a little personal. I don't know if I can talk about that on camera, Shilah Mae.
Anyway, based on this conversation, was there anything else that you talked about that's noteworthy?
I don't remember, but it was the sort of flippant casual conversation you would have with strangers at 2 in the morning at an all-night restaurant when there are about 12 other people at the table.
Oh, okay, so he wasn't only talking to you.
No, he was sitting across from me. He might have been trying to decide whether I was a victim worthy or not, I'd like to think. I have a side of me with very low self-esteem. And you
Yeah,
may have
that's quite
sensed that
obvious
by
facts. It's quite
what?
obvious. It's quite obvious facts.
Oh, well, thank you. Thank you. That's very perceptive of you, dear. But I also have a side that does not have low self-esteem, and he may have realized that I wouldn't be a suitable victim after all.
Yeah, I think that you were a little too old for him. I mean, you were
Oh.
already 60 years old, I imagine, back then. So.
Yeah, but well, this was pre-Botox, so I didn't have the wonders of technology available to you. But, a kill is a kill. If he was having a slow night, you know, he may have considered it.
Well, I'm just saying that because based on the victims' profiles that, you know, we now know, it seemed like all of the eventual victims were definitely out of your age range, so.
No, that's true. That's true. But, you know, he may have wanted a little variety to his diet, you know, or something like that.
So did he ever offer you to buy you a drink?
No, he didn't.
Or to drive you home?
No.
Or to take you back to his place?
No, I'm afraid not.
So
you're unraveling my narrative here, Shilah. You're supposed to build up a narrative, not tear it down.
Well, but, the narrative surrounds, I tell the story here.
I always forget it's your show. I'm sorry.
Yeah. It's not the Facts show. It's the Grace and Andrew Yang show.
Okay.
So, I guess it never transformed into a one-night stand.
No. Janis Joplin would have been very disappointed.
Was that someone that you had a crush on?
Yeah. Many moons ago.
You know that when she was alive, a lot of people often bashed her for her appearance.
That's true. And now they're sorry.
Yes. But did you always see the beauty in Janis?
Yes. She was beautiful inside where it was darker.
And so you only met him once, is that correct?
That's right.
So you never spoke to him again, I assume?
No. But I know I liked him as a person. I thought he would have made a nice friend.
Okay, so now shortly after your fateful encounter with the organism, full name Jeffrey Lionel Dahmer, an arrest was made on said organism where the release of truly horrific details surrounding the case captured the attention of literally millions of people in this country. Where were you when it happened?
I realized it when I saw the Chicago Sun-Times headline and saw the picture.
Oh, what are the Sun-Times? Because I've never heard of that news network.
Oh, it's not a TV channel, so you may not have heard of it. It was a newspaper. That's a charming 20th century thing.
Mean 19th century.
That's what I meant. Because back in those days, people couldn't write clever comments at the end of the article.
Uh-huh.
Once you wrote an article, that was it. You didn't get to hear people's clever comments or get to see them argue amongst themselves over the content of the article.
Yes, and I remember that you also would not be saving trees in those days.
Oh, of course not.
How unfriendly.
Okay. Trees can't fight back. What are they going to do about it?
They're going to fall on you.
Not if you don't go hiking, they won't.
So at that moment when you knew that this organism named Jeffrey Lionel Dahmer, somebody that you met and talked to during the midst of his crime spree, was arrested on TV to be held on what would be a trial of the century. How did that make you feel?
I don't know if I can. I don't know if I can even talk about that, Shilah Mae.
It's Shilah Grace.
Shilah, that's what I said. She, shy, she,
And why
shy.
is that?
Miss Grace. It was so traumatizing that even now, wait, even now, I hesitate to bring it up. All those memories come streaming back.
I'm
And
sorry,
it's
dear.
all
I
your
thought that
fault.
you wanted to talk about surviving Jeffrey Dahmer, but you know what? I completely understand. Some victims have survivor's guilt and feel guilty about having lived when others were not so fortunate, so they don't wish to talk about their good fortunes. Let's talk more about Jeffrey.
I've always felt guilty about being old, even when I was a boy. Now, here I am, an old man, and all of his victims were so young. It just doesn't seem fair.
So from that moment, surely you understood that you became a survivor.
Yes.
Did you at any point of time since the encounter imagine that you could have been one of the victims?
It's hard to imagine.
Facts, I really hope. And I really do. I really hope that you know how truly close you were to the face of danger. Frankly, it's a miracle that you are even with us today.
Oh, I am. I'm very grateful.
You should be. So at that
Well,
moment, when you saw the conviction of Jeffrey Lionel Dahmer play out, the sentencing, the delivery of verdict, a verdict of multiple murder, ones guilty had been rendered by that Wisconsin jury. And what a moment it was indeed. I could still hear the sheer silence of the courtroom soon followed by the burst of joy when Jeffrey Lionel Dahmer was sentenced to 15 terms of life imprisonment. Everyone, the celebration across the nation that this ordeal is nearly over. To all the people who amassed in support of the victims and in support of our system, repeat, guilty, guilty, guilty of murder, one count four, the slaughter of unarmed innocents. Straight out to you, facts. How did you react to this landmark sentencing?
Shayla, I think you should stop watching Perry Mason on MeTV.
Who the hell is that?
It's got your it's got your you've got your news face on backwards. But I will say that when I saw his picture in the paper, my heart sunk inside.
Out of sadness or
Out of shock, like, oh, I recognized him and I said, here's somebody I thought was a nice person. who turned out to be not so nice.
Yeah. You were very shocked, I assume?
Yes. Shocked and disappointed.
So do you think that this sentence was fair and just?
Yes, murder should not be encouraged.
Thax, if you could just imagine that you could say anything to Jeffrey once more, what would those words be?
I hope you're satisfied.
Do you think he was?
Well, his legend burns across the sky like a shining meteor. That's not too
I think that's a highly inappropriate comparison, Thax.
He's been dead for 30 years, almost, and we're still talking about him.
Yeah, but definitely not in the sky.
But people still, you know, people love celebrity. And, you know, lots of people would kill to be a star, and that's what Jeffrey did. He killed himself to the top.
Oh, did you just say that he killed himself?
Well,
because I heard Mr. Fax Machine Douglas that he was stabbed while in prison.
That's true. That's true. Isn't it funny that the guy who shot John Lennon is still alive, but they killed Jeffrey Dahmer? Where's the justice in that, I ask you?
Well, that's what happens when you have a whole country that cannot agree on where to implement the death penalty.
That's true.
Right. So anyway, with that, we are running out of time, but I want to thank you, Thax, for coming on to here and telling the world about your frightening encounter with Jeffrey Lionel Dahmer. And thank goodness that you're still around to tell of that story.
Thank you, Shilah. I only thought it was my duty. And let this be a warning to all your viewers out there. Never trust anyone, no matter how nice they seem.
Yes.
Remember, they might be a murderer and you don't even know it. So don't trust anyone.
And don't ever get into the car of a stranger.
Even if they offer you a ride.
Right. So with that, you are watching the Grace and Andrew Yang Show. I am Shilah Mae Grace, and goodbye.